Times of Asia's second richest man, Gautam Adani's group, fell on Monday on reports suggesting the account of three foreign funds frozen by the NSDL. Now, these three funds are said to have a staggering investment of 43,500 crores in Adani Group companies. Of course, the stocks tanked on Monday, but few of them extended losses on Tuesday too, with three counters hitting the lower circuit, even as Adani Group denied reports that NSDL had frozen these accounts. But it is correct that NSDL froze accounts of these three foreign funds, but that pertains to some specific accounts which happened way back in 2016 June. These specific accounts were frozen on SEBI orders in an unrelated case and has nothing to do with Adani Group companies. But the fact of the matter is, these stocks continue to be in the limelight. Some of them even made a U-turn on Tuesday to get back to their winning ways.
The various listed entities under Adani's ambit have grown from a minimum of 120% for Adani Ports and SEZ to a staggering 1000% returns for Adani Total Gas over the last 1 year. As a result of that, the entire basket of Adani Group stocks now trade at extremely premium valuations. However, following the news of NSDL freezing accounts of Albula Investment Fund, Cresta Fund and APMS Investment Fund, which together own more than 43,500 crores worth of shares in Adani Enterprises, Adani Green Energy, Adani Transmission and Adani Total Gas, there was a significant market cap erosion seen in just a matter of 1 day. Monday's downfall wiped off more than 53,000 crores in market cap from all of Adani's listed entities combined.
Despite the crash, Adani Group continues to rule the list of top 30 most valuable companies of India by market cap. There are only 5 non-Nifty companies, in fact, that fall under this elite list, and 4 of them belong to the Adani Group. The market cap of Adani Green is higher than Nifty companies like Nestle, JSW Steel. Adani Enterprises' market cap is higher than Sun Pharma, and Adani Total Gas's market cap is higher than PSU giant ONGC.
3 years ago, Adani had no play in India's airports business. His significant interests in power generation and transmission, mining and ports had bestowed on him the tag of India's second richest billionaire with a wealth of $58 billion. Over the years, Adani companies, both listed and unlisted ones, have managed to grab leadership positions across various sectors and industries on several fronts. Both organic and inorganic strategies have played a role in attaining this position. Adanis have been on a shopping spree since 2014 with a host of purchases and investments across businesses from ports to power to airports and gas distribution. The companies have also laid out ambitious growth targets over the next 3 to 4 years.
Much of the Adani Group's growth is fueled by debt, and even future growth is dependent on bank lending. Adani Group's debt is at a whopping 1.37 lakh crores. In fact, Brickwork Ratings stated in a report last September that the debt instruments issued by the group's flagship firm, Adani Enterprises, carry very low credit risk. Meanwhile, SEBI has received multiple complaints about Adani Group companies' shareholding. The markets regulator has taken cognizance of these complaints and also taken note of the stupendous rise seen.